Lesson, good morning to all. Please all rise as we begin our service this morning. Would you please say good morning to your katapads, no? Maing buntag, good morning to all. God bless you. Happy to see you in church today. And join me in prayer. As we gather here, Heavenly Father, it is our desire that we will meet you, worship you, and listen to you, cast our cares upon you, so we can be equipped to face whatever is ahead of us. Help us as we do this through Christ our Lord. Amen, amen. Please remain standing. Kate, our worship minister, will lead us this morning.
Good morning, church. We thank God for the gift of music, for the privilege that we have today that we can sing the songs to Him with gratefulness in our hearts.
We're here to bless Your name, gathered as Your family, to praise You and proclaim Your faithfulness.
Chapter 3, verses 15 to 16. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness to God in your hearts. As we sing this song, let us be reminded of God has been faithful for all that He allowed to happen in our lives, including the good and bad. For we trust that He is the all-wise, all-sovereign, and yes, all-loving God. Here we are, lifting our hands to You. All You do, and as we
a clap of appreciation. Lord, we worship you today. Our coming to church is in response to the grace of God. And the grace of God, the appropriate and most humbling response is gratitude. But there's just one problem. We are very forgetful people. So before I ask Pastor Fritz Tom to lead us in our prayer of gratitude, pangayo ta og tabang sa Holy Spirit, ask the Holy Spirit to recall in our minds situations wherein it was clear to us, it was all of God's grace. Let us ask the Spirit, Lord, bring to our mind situations this week, last week, wherein crystal clear is your grace. Could have been this morning when we woke up. Father, only then when it is crystal clear grace, we can say thank you in your name. Let us personally, before Pastor Tom will lead our prayer, let us individually give thanks to God. Lord, thank you in your context. Lord, have mercy. Thank you for strength for today that I can serve you. Thank you. Thank you for life, for breath. Thank you. Thank you for seeing people worshiping, humbled by people raising their hands and bowing down to you, young and old, rich and poor. Lord, we're here to worship. Let's join Reverend Fritz Tong as he leads us in this prayer of gratitude.
Let us join our hearts as we give thanks to our Lord. Gracious God and Heavenly Father, we are so grateful once again that you have provided us this day a fresh way to start, a new day, because your mercies, they are new every morning. Understanding that you are faithful, guiding us through this course of life. And as you lead us in this life, whether leading us in the still water or in the darkest valley, your promise that you will be with us, teaching us to be more like you, teaching us to reflect and contemplate on the good things and excellent things that most matter, that matters most, such as love, faith, and hope. Thank you, O God, for the faith that you have provided to us, our faith in you, that gives us perspective on the meaning of worship and delighting to call upon your name, despite of our limitations, for we were once blind that cannot see the beauty of worship, but because of your grace, we find delight in coming into this place, knowing that you are the God who draws us near to you. Truly, without faith, we cannot please you. And so in drawing us to you, we see your face smiling towards us. Thank you for the hope that you provide, the hope in you. And in that, in every aspect of our life, in every vocation that you have provided, we give thanks because the hope that we have allows us to make choices, to make the right choices despite of an unpopular decision. We thank you for every work, every vocation that you have provided in the medical field, construction area, in our ministry, we give thanks. We thank you also for the love that you have provided, because in that, we also know how to love. We learn to love because you first loved us, allowing us to know what it means to celebrate birthdays and anniversaries, to those who were able to finish their task, to accomplish another step of stage of their life. Thank you, O God, we can celebrate with them. Continue to just guide us that we would cherish and contemplate on these good things, faith, love, and hope. We give thanks in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please be seated. The prayer reminds us of one word that has resonated in my heart since this morning, and I think it's a personal message for me. Faith. Let us renew our faith in God. Amen. Father Henry Nouwen was saying, you don't need to be addicted to predict the future in order to have hope for today. God is here, and that's enough, a perspective enough to lead us tomorrow. We cannot survive life without the prayer of others and without the prayer for the church. First of all, I want to share good news. Last Sunday, I asked you to help the Methodist Church. Our board will still meet next week, but you already gave, at least in my counting, last Sunday we gave 39,000 plus to the United Methodist Church. To God be the glory. I gave that already to Mam Pableo, and some are still coming. And if you are still desirous to give, give it to any of our pastor. I assure you, they are very honest. They will not put that in their own pocket. They will give that to the Methodist Church. And Kaduha, we rejoice with the United Church of Christ, Philippines, in Matina. They celebrate, if I am not mistaken, their 80th anniversary today. Congratulations to the UCCP Matina. And according to Pastor Melvin, there will be lunch. So after the service, all of you go to UCCP Matina for lunch. But it's a joy to celebrate with other churches. That's the beauty of gospel partnership. This morning, who among you came to church who needs prayer in the area of finances, health, conflict, and whatever problem you might have brought, bring it to God and let the church pray for you. Will you stand? By standing, you're saying, ako to, I need prayer. I am struggling with this. I need the church to pray for me. Amen, amen. It's a beautiful reaction to be unembarrassed to stand for prayer. We are standing before you, Abba, because we all, one way or the other, will always be in need of you, in need of wisdom. And Lord, remind us that there are prayers, blessings that you cannot give if we don't ask. Protection you will give even if we don't ask. Healing you will give even if we don't ask. Pero wisdom, spiritual awakening, we need to request. And therefore this morning, Abba, many have financial problems. Make it our goal that at the end of the year, by your grace and mercy, that we will have paid all our outstanding loans. And Lord, having the habit of loaning without praying is not right. And therefore we ask for wisdom, that we are not easily scammed by offers. Wisdom to discern, wisdom even as we click this online thing, we order this, we order that. God, somehow it's very addictive nowadays. We need you. And the blessing that you have provided, dili na noon maadto kung asa dapat, because we don't have wisdom. So we ask for contentment. Lord, a contented heart is a grateful heart. One house is enough. Not 20, not 30, not one car, if the family fits and the needs are met, enough. Help us to just rejoice in the enough. Lord, for healing. Nowadays, we ask for grace. Yes, we exercise. Yes, we take vitamins, but more than that, Lord, remind us that you are the source of life and healing. Please have mercy, especially those who are undergoing processes that it looks like a lifetime, like dialysis and chemo. Bangitahon, Lord, life is short, and in this short life, make a difference in our lives, Abba. Relationships are fragile. Sometimes we are afraid to relate because we have a share of broken ones. And therefore, we pray for courage to say sorry, courage to stand, even to correct a friend if necessary, with an attitude of grace. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. We lift up the Methodist Church as they rebuild the house of worship. More than the building, rebuild the worshipers. We pray for the UCCP Church as they celebrate their 80-plus anniversary here in this city. Hallelujah. And in everyone who is rejoicing, we give thanks. Please, God, please, Lord Jesus, blessed Holy Spirit, whisper to our ears that the prayers were all heard. In Jesus' name, amen. Please all rise for the Gloria Patri. To read this text from the scripture 3 times, and as we read this, listen to the Holy Spirit. Let us read Isaiah 41:10 3 times. First reading, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged. Amen. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand. Second reading, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand. Third reading, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand. All God's people say, amen. My dear brothers and sisters, the verse is comforting, but the verse is also convicting. Same verse, God is saying, do not bow down to your fears. Bow down to me. Amen. There are times, I'm sorry to admit, I've been attacked with anxiety lately. I bow down to my fear. Therefore, that verse became a convicting verse. Believe me. We need to repent when we bow down to our fears more than God. Let us pray. Forgive us, Lord, for the simple and yet the sin of worry is never sinful. Sinful, yeah? It drains us. Forgive us, Lord, for asking more evidence that you are true. Forgive us, Lord, for demanding for more of your presence. For the first prayer is already enough faith. And we believe what you said. You're with me. You're holding me. You will help me. And to doubt that and disbelieve that is not honoring to you. So Lord, as a church, as individual, sa Ilogit Town, my Lord, nadalami sa among hadlok, sa kawadon, nadalami sa mga hulga sa panahon, we have been drawn to fear instead of faith. Oh God, have mercy. Cleanse us through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Some few instructions before we proceed, because this has been a practice of yesterday, but somehow in the middle we have forgotten, and the Lord, hallelujah, gently reminded us. As you see in front, the kneeling pads are back. That's a good symbol that Chinese Baptist Church, we must humbly admit that somehow we have forgotten to bow down and pray. When you kneel down, it is not mandatory. It is out of your conviction. But a privilege to kneel before the Lord. What is the difference between the first two, three prayers? The prayers we're about to do is a personal prayer between you and God. Prayers that you're not comfortable sharing with a pastor, with a friend, but you go directly to your Heavenly Father. You believe there are prayers like that? Yes. You will never be understood by anyone except the one who made you. So my encouragement is, as Kate leads us in the song, if you feel convicted, come to the altar. And if the altar is filled, get a kneeling pad. Balik lang mamaya. Kneel down if you can. If you have vertigo, don't. And if you are not comfortable, don't. But the privilege to say, God, bugat na kaya ni ba? I'm giving this to you. And whatever that might be, details not shared to us, details shared to our Heavenly Father. Nindot ba yan, eh? I mean, it gives me strength. It reminds me. And then later, after the song is done, we will all go back to prayer. You can still, if you don't want to come to the altar, there is a kneeling pad in your pew, siguro three pads per pew. You can get one and right there, kneel and say, God, muluhod ko ron. It's not, am I clear that this is not something required? This is something, a venue wherein we can respond to God. Like raising of hands is not required, but some of you raise hands. It's a beautiful sight. Kung naalang mo dire, no, everyone who stands here cannot be proud. You know why? When you see God's people worshiping, you will melt here. You would realize, I'm too small, God is too big. Please all rise, and Kate will lead us in this song. And as the song starts, you can start coming forward. If you like, come kneel, maybe husband and wife, or maybe individual. I'll do that myself, and then later I'll join you in prayer. Kate, will you lead us in this song? And
the fall in his wonder.
remember one character in the Old Testament by the name of King Hezekiah. When the bad news came that the enemy will attack, he brought the letter of Sennacherib, the threat, knelt down before God and presented the letter and said, "Lord, dugmok ang kasing-kasing sa Ginoo, no, kung we just be broken before Him. Start young and keep in that position, you'll survive life." The altar is still open for those who want to come. Those of you who wants to kneel down, the kneeling pad is there. Let's all do that if you want. Sit, kneel, whatever. Let's pray. Let's all do that. Now, makalingkod, makaluhod, let us all pray. And you bring to the Lord what is in your heart. You can sit down if you want and kneel down if you want. Like Hezekiah. Pray, bring your prayers to the Lord. Bring it to God. Lord, have mercy. Holy Spirit, assure us that the prayers were heard. Amen. Holy Spirit, temper our efforts without your help. Temper our entitlement, our demands. We rest our case in the altar like Hezekiah. You now take care of the rest. In Jesus' name, humbly we pray. Amen. 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 This morning, we have a special ceremony, very simple, because we want to dedicate to the Lord the position of Senior Associate Pastor, which is occupied by Pastor David Tan. And as I have reminded you, this is not just a promotion, it is a reminder that you are a slave of the Lord Jesus Christ. And because of that, we need more prayers for Pastor Dave. So the pastors, the deacons will be praying for him. The whole congregation will lay hands. The deacons and the pastors will lay hands. And to put officially David, Reverend David Tan as Senior Associate Pastor. As of now, we have two, Dr. Jerry on one hand and Pastor David on the other hand. Just a little history. I think one of the happiest person here is Pastor Jerry himself, because in Baguio City, David's pastor is Jerry, no? David's, the one who officiated his marriage with si Jerry rin. And now, they are equally serving in the same position. So I ask you, Pastor Dave, will you kneel down? And then we will lift you up in prayer. The kneeling down is humbling before the Lord. Hands and the deacons, will you please come and lay hands on David as co-servants, Jerry, Captain Jerry Francisco, and Don and Wilson. The deacons will lay hands. Ask God for grace. His job is tough. Pray that God will grant mercy. And then surrounding the deacons are the pastors. Would you please come and be with them? Sa likod lang mo form a semi-circle. Pastors are coming as our co-worker for Pastor Dave. There should be no competition in the ministry of Christ. And we lay hands on him. There was a time that an ordination was not respected. This is different. We will do that in the fear of the Lord. Now the congregation, please rise. And if it is not too much, extend your hands like that in full support of what's going on here. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, my dear brother David Tan, the Holy Spirit puts you in a position where you will bleed, you will be broken, you will cry, you will be humbled, you will be crushed. But by the mercy of God, you will be a true servant of the gospel. We lay hands on you because you are not alone in this journey. You will be insulted and we will not retaliate. You will be a servant of Jesus Christ, slaves with joy. And therefore I pray now, all entitlement be surrendered, all addiction to power be lifted up to you. And Lord Jesus, we pray the same for ourselves, we who are your pastors. God have mercy in these days where ministry is a suspect. Spare this young man. We already had our share. We don't want that again. Lord have mercy. We don't want to shame your name. Have mercy on us. In the name of the Father and of the Son and the blessed Holy Spirit, Reverend David Tan, by the authority of the Holy Spirit given to the church, you are placed in this holy position. Not boss, not controller, servant, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. A round of applause for... Please all be seated. Pastor Dave, will you come up here? Pastor Jerry, please join me. Where is Pastor Jerry? Ah, you're there. Sorry, I did not see you. We will now put on the robe, like this one, a symbol of nothingness, all of God. No, you won't see David, you will see the cross. And as we put this onto him, officially he is installed in the position. Welcome to Hogwarts Baptist Church. It's the tradition of the church to wear this, so you will not be surprised every time he preaches, he'll wear that. Every time he officiate wedding, he'll wear that. Please all rise. The first ministry of day, he will lead us in the reading of the scriptures.
Let us continue to magnify the Lord as we read Philippians chapter 1, verse 15 to 19. Let's all read this together. It's true that some are preaching out of jealousy and rivalry, but others preach about Christ with pure motives. They preach because they love me, for they know I have been appointed to defend the good news. Those others do not have pure motives as they preach about Christ. They preach with selfish ambition, not sincerely, intending to make my chains more painful to me. But that doesn't matter. Whether their motives are false or genuine, the message about Christ is being preached either way. So I rejoice, and I will continue to rejoice. For I know that as you pray for me, and the Spirit of Jesus Christ helps me, This will lead to my deliverance. This is the word of God. This is the word of life. And we respond, thanks be to God.
Remain standing, please. We will honor the Lord with one more hymn, and Kate will lead us. I would like to announce to you that this coming Holy Week, I am challenging the church. Have you prayed in your own recollection? Nakaampo ka na ba nga 1 hour? I am not asking you to do penance or sacrifice, but just a question. Have you experienced giving God 1 hour in prayer? If not, this is a good chance. On Holy Thursday, that's the month of March, the church will be open on 5 a.m. until 6 p.m. Will you give God 1 hour? Come to church. No service. No one. No pastor leading. Just get the kneeling pad. Sit down for 1 hour. Talk to God. So many things to catch up. Amen? So many things to catch up. Believe me, 1 hour is not enough. The pastors will do the same. But we will have different schedules. Ako, because I'm a morning person, I might choose 5 to 6 or 6 to 7. Join us in Holy Thursday if you want that. 1 hour in prayer, listening, crying, pouring out your hearts to God, giving thanks, asking for direction. 1 hour. Believe me, you will not regret it. At first, it's hard, pero in my experience, 1 hour is too short for the many things that we need to talk to God. We'll provide coffee at the lobby at that time. Baka after your prayer, you need some hot drink that will be provided. I'll ask Wilson to do that. And then enjoy time of prayer. We are talking about the letter of Paul to the Philippians, and he is saying, I am grateful to God that I have a partner church that helps me fulfill the purpose of God. By now, I hope you realize that it is not God's design that you serve Him alone. It is God's design that you serve Him alone. All God's people say, Amen. Having said that, the general statements are nice, but the details are challenging. After Paul said, what a joy to have you with me. He is not gonna sugarcoat everything. Mingon si Pablo, nindot nga kauban ta pag-alagad sa Ginoo. But in Chinese we say, ren silang, people will be people. It is not at all true that if you are a Christian, I am a Christian, there will be no more tension in the relationship. Believe me, there is. In fact, a lot of you are saying, siguro kung sa church lang ko nagtrabaho, wala yung tension. You're wrong. Maybe I'll join the ministry, the mission, so that everybody will be nice. May God have mercy on your naive soul. Because that's not true. Even among us pastors, we have tension. And the verses that you read, Paul did not hide that. And siguro karong buntag, we will learn something. May baon kita bago mag-uli. Our general topic is joyful partnership in the gospel. And Paul said, I have you, Philippians, with me as partners. But the details of that, we're still human. And therefore, we need to learn this truth. Joy-filled partnership in the gospel is not threatened by competition. Na padi ay na. Well, I assure you, competition is not bad. That's why we say it could be healthy. But I think the issue this morning is how can we respond in a godly way in the midst of this very, very competitive world? If competition is still true in ministry, how much more in the secular? I hate to use the word secular in ministry, but for the sake of emphasis. Read with me verse 15. Altogether, 1, 2, 3. It's true that some are preaching out of jealousy and rivalry, but others preach about Christ with pure motives. The verse is loaded with two categories. Category one, those who preach. Well, not do evil, huh? They do good things. Those who preach, but their motive is jealousy. That's a category one. Category two, those who preach with pure motives. Please do not miss the application. The application is not to inspect those who preach with jealousy. Now, the application is not to label them and brand them. The application is, let us all examine our motives before God that we may serve Him with pure motives, all God's people say. However, I have to clarify, if you examine yourself, your own, you are a very good lawyer for yourself. In my experience, self-examination cannot work. It has to be Holy Spirit examination of self. Amen. If you talk to yourself, check yourself, believe me, You are very good in defending yourself. It could be like this. Maayo man akong motibo, nindot man akong kasing-kasing, bisang nangawat ko, ako man tong gitabang sa uban. I mean, that's the way how self will defend itself. Tama? Believe me, even your own repentance is not yours. It has to be conviction from the Holy Spirit and then respond in obedience to that conviction. Minus that conviction, no one will repent. So therefore, this morning, I want you to look at that sin that we don't really take seriously. It's called jealousy. If there is jealousy, next is rivalry. Remember, the context of this is not sales. The context of this is not business. The context of this is ministry. Very embarrassing. The context of this is serving Christ. Mutumog sa dili. The truth hurts, but there are a lot of Christian works today. What inspired that work is jealousy. Maybe a church split, and then they would say, we will baptize more to shame the church where we come from. Or maybe a pastor was kicked out and he wants to prove. That's the problem. Every one of the 15 pastors here in church, you have their own little loyalists. Ibig sabihin, each one is so capable of splitting this church into tiny, miserable pieces. And one pastor lives, along with him, 100 members. Another Baptist church is born. And there's a lot of church growth that is a product of jealousy and rivalry. And with all humility in my heart, I apologize, for many pastors are not exempted from jealousy. In fact, because of our immaturity, a lot of us, you have read our fights in Facebook. I don't know, that's a shame. Whether you are a pastor or a missionary, you wash your dirty linen on Facebook, I don't think Christ is ever glorified. I believe we lost the sense of courageously talking it over. And the Facebook is now our defense. That itself is draining. It's draining the joy of partnership, and it is blocking the purpose of God's kingdom. Now, having said that, who do you remember as a jealous person in the Bible? Can you guess? I have only one. There are many, pero di gyud mahawa sa akong nahuna. King Saul. Remember this guy? King Saul. Blessed already, honored already, powerful already, and yet threatened with the popularity of David. It all started with the songs of the women. David killed 10,000. Saul killed 1,000. Di na siya katulog. Instead of having an ally, his most loyal ally, he would take a javelin and throw it to David. And then that's the story started. Naisip ko lang, no? Are you aware that because of your obsessive jealousy, you miss friendship? You miss the delight of relating to others? Are you aware, my dear friends, that as we talked about the jealousy of the missionaries, the jealousy of the pastor, no one is exempted? My prayer is, deal with it by the grace of God. Do not live with a jealous heart, because you will never find joy. If ever you find joy, fake joy. Because your joy is when you prove that you are better than the others. Ang masakit, ana, mga bata pa ang itong mga kabataan, they're already brainwashed with competition, proving that you're better than the other. No, no, sir. There's always somebody born better than you. Ama? I have bad news for you. They're twins. And I don't know, I think if every Bible seminary is listening to the broadcast, I don't know who invented that part among Bible schools in Davao, gitawag nga preaching contest. I don't know where did that come from. I believe it is not right. Though I was one of the contestants. Hey, sudyante pa man ko ato. The school represented, I represented Halls of Life Bible College, the Nazarene, Church of God, PBTS and the other Baptist, the other seminary, we are in one big, ano, ah, grabe na, pa-anointinay na ni. Guess who won? Not me. Second ko, napildi ko sa babae nga magwawali. Masama man di mapildi nga ang mabunot mang kag-verse. And then walay outline, walay time to study. Get the verse, you have time. O expontereños, ano siya na? Extemporeños, preach it. Ah, nako. Lisod pa kaya kung verse na pili. Masama nili ko mapildi nga. Di lang. Naman to sa ilang teritoryo. No, siyempre, daog yun ang sa mga niya, Church of God. You know, the lady preacher of Church of God. So I went home a little bit sad. I should be the best preacher. You know, in our Bible school, modesty aside, I was awarded the best preacher of the year and then mapildir ako sa lady preacher. May gulay. I recall that night, I went home feeling bad, and the Holy Spirit is saying, oh, you need that. What I'm saying, my dear friend, jealousy is a major, major sin. Proverbs 14:30. If you don't believe me, at least believe the word of God. Amen? Read it aloud with me. A peaceful heart leads to a healthy body, but jealousy is like cancer in the bones. So sometimes health in your body is not related to the vitamin you take and the exercise you're doing. Though they are all very important, it is also very connected to the spiritual life you walked. Amen. Because a person who is jealous and obsessed with jealousy, I assure you, your blood pressure will shoot up. Your sugar will be at the highest peak without taking sugar. Makapatay na yung jealousy. Dili ni related sa bintana, ha? Jealousy is terrible. It kills, it drains, it zaps. That's why Paul said, the joyful partnership should not be threatened by jealousy. Now, having described that, do you have that in your heart? If the Holy Spirit convicts you today that your main problem is jealousy, you please do not end the service without repenting, all God's people say. Do not continue to live the remaining months of this year still a jealous person. I will tone down a little. I was hard at the 7 o'clock, but realization came to me. If you are in a relationship, a little piece of advice, not to attempt to prescribe, but out of experience. If you are a woman related, uyab-uyab, no? You have a boyfriend, and if you're looking for a lifetime partner, consider this true. Consider, I am not making an ex-cathedra here, basing makatabang. Do not marry, choose a man who is jealous. You will live an unhappy marriage life, believe me. Why did I focus on the man? Ambot, lahi ang sa babae, lahi ang sa lalaki. Ang lalaki sobra kasiloso, die samtang naapay panahon. Break it to me gently. You are married to a jealous husband, I tell you, I don't want to elaborate on that, but if it's not yet too late, and if you are the husband I'm talking about, you better be on your knees. Because if you die, even if wife or husband, if you die obsessed with jealousy, the embalmers will not have an easy time making you up. Kay ang taong siloso, mag-text yung taga-anghel sa Cosmos, sa St. Peter's, tangil-arag yung tingdag, di na ni madalag formalin. And therefore, welcome to cremation. And even in cremation, they need to intensify the heat. Because if a person so jealous, you are laughing, but I am serious. Believe me, if you don't commit that to Jesus, forget about joy. Forget about spiritual delight. It has to go in the name of Christ. Amen. Paul said. They preach because they love me, for they know I have been appointed to defend the good news. But those others have pure motives, do not have pure motives as they preach Christ. They preach with selfish ambition, not sincerely, intending to make my chains more painful. There is only one application here. The application is not to find out who are those others. That's not the application. What is the application? Do not be those others. Amen? The application is not to find out, kinisya. No, no. You will have a long list. But the application there is for me, for you, for Paul. Do not serve Christ with a wrong motive. It dishonors God and it destroys you. But verse 18, I love that verse 18. I would say it's a spiritual ambition. I would say it's a spiritual desire na maabot ka sa panahon na makaingon pod ka sama ni Pablo. Bisan kung nagwali sila, mabali ilang motibo, they preach with jealousy, they criticize me, they destroy me. Blessed is the person who in the boldness and humility and power of the Lord Jesus Christ can say, it doesn't matter. All God's people say. I mean, I want you to go home. If I can only add holy envy, that makes it clear. Make it your spiritual desire to be that kind of a person. Madili na ta, madala sa selos, kung giselosan man, we can honestly say, doesn't matter. Amen? And if you are that person, believe me, you will have no problem with spiritual delight. It will be oozing, it will be contagious, it will define your journey. But as Paul said that, he said, whether their motives are false or genuine, the message about Christ is being preached either way. So I rejoice and I continue to rejoice. There are two truths under that verse. Number one, Paul is so sure that the only hope for true transformation in our world today is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You tried it. I tried it. In politics, so many politicians have promised to change the world. In social work, you tried your best to feed the poor, cure the disease, give food, sacrifice, you know, protect the climate, a lot of that. But change did not happen. Whether you are in the Communist Party, you know, if the Communist Party will only be true to their words that justice for all, I think there will be change. But there is a problem. When they tasted power, they become monsters themselves. Well, let us not exempt the church. The church is so dirty today that even among ministers, that's why we wear black, symbol of dirt. We are not credible. In other words, even churches, a lot of you can say, if not for the grace of God, if I only look at pastors, believe me, I would have been stumbled long time ago and we apologize. And that's true. You see, my dear friends, I asked my daughter one time and she said, if in case daddy falls into sin, how will you take that? I will admire her for her answer and it is humbling to me and I will share that to you. My daughter said, gagmay pa mi. They were still small. I have already trained myself not to put people on the pedestal. Hallelujah. So I have space for you, Dad. The more I tremble. I have trained myself not to put people in the pedestal. What is the meaning of that? The meaning of that is people will fall. We will have a problem with jealousy. You think pastors dili mi mga siloso? I don't think so. We still struggle with that. The last part there, sabi ni Paul, I rejoice. Sana yun lang, no? Pero naabi ay dugang, I will continue to rejoice. Did you sense there is something in that verse? I rejoice, I will continue to rejoice. Can you not sense that in between the two statements is a vulnerable struggle? Sometimes their criticism gets into my nerve. Ako wala ko problema, you fight me, but if you touch my children and my wife, that's another story. Are you with me? Sometimes it's unfair. Pastors are criticized so unfairly. If we eat too much, dalo. If we eat little, gusto ko mo, agikaon, asa man ibutang. Diba? Parang, sabi ni Pablo, I will continue to rejoice. As I read that scripture, I sense the honesty of Paul. There are times I don't like to rejoice because the jealousy of others is unfair. Listen to me. There are two things here. Number one, deal with your own jealousy. Surrender that to the great physician. Have it removed. All God's people say. Are you with me? Seriously, deal with your jealousy. Because jealousy and envy are different. Though the same, pero different. What's the difference? Jealousy connotes hostility. When you are jealous, you are few steps from doing some crazy things, killing people, putting them down, maligning their name, demolishing their character, and then when they are defeated, you rejoice, wrong rejoicing. In other words, if you are a jealous person, you will be hostile. Few steps more, and you will find some illegal means, immoral means, to put a person down. Before you reach that state, in the name of Jesus, do not end this service without repenting. Amen. I have my own jealousy. You see, what if next Sunday, you give new car to all of the associate pastor except me? What do you think I will do? Mingon pa ko, well, I'm happy for them. Oh no, I'll kill them. I don't know. Tao ka lang eh. So, mahimo, ayaw na lang ninyo. Gimo, ha? Kung maghatag mo, siguro, para world peace. Ba, magbigay ka kay David, magbigay ka kay Fritz, o kay Jerry. Eh, daan nyo muna sa akin. Pastor, ibigay, o David, o para daw sa'yo. Di, I feel better. No, that's wrong. That's not the solution. I smile because I know of a story of two great men of God who preached the word of God. Kasi dalawa yan eh. You are jealous, deal with that. Can I go to the second? What will you do with people who are jealous with you? Huh? What do you do with people who are jealous with you? You have to react in a godly way. Amen? Gisilusan ka. In fact, I told of a pastor, Pastor, nga nung gisilusan mo ko nila, gamay man ako simbahan, 20 lang akong membro, 15 pa ang natulog. Nga nung ilang akong silusan? Why are they envious of me? And I say, they are not envious of you because of your church or your members. They are envious of you because despite all of this, you are full of joy. My dear friend, you don't have to be rich. You don't have to be powerful. If you are a person so full of joy, despite your situation, people will not be happy. So how do you deal with that? Back to the story. F.B. Meyer is a powerful preacher. Very good expositor of the gospel. Pero G. Campbell Morgan, the one who succeeded Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones, and if you're reading history, I am mentioning to you the giants in the world of preaching. F.B. Meyer, G. Campbell Morgan. F.B. Meyer enjoys a full-packed church like this, but when Campbell Morgan preaches, it is double or tripled and unaware. Jealousy starts to be there. So sabi ni F.B. Meyer, mbalhin na lang ko to deal with the jealousy. So he transferred to another place. Lo and behold, location, change of location, change of job is not the solution. It's the change of heart. Surrender that to the physician. Are you jealous with your boss? Are you jealous? You know, jealousy is not provoked by someone better than you. Jealousy is provoked by someone not better than you, but he's doing good. Anak mo'y makapatay ba? Classmate ko, nakabugo anin niya. Grabe na siya. Siyempre, siya may tagiyas kumpanya. So balik kay F.B. Meyer, lumipat siya ng simbahan. And then months later, church grew. No? People came. But God, the God of humor, allowed Dr. Campbell Morgan to accept a call from a nearby church near Dr. Mayer. So he said, it's not the place. He went to God and pray. I think that's what we need to do. Amen? Are you dealing with that? I'm not sure. I am certain that this message is not an accident. A lot of us cannot not deal with it until this service ends, or cannot live with it throughout the next remaining months of life. Dr. Mayer prayed. I like his prayer. He said, Lord, fill Dr. Morgan's church to overflowing. Unya ang mga nabilin nga wala nay malingkuran diri sa kuha. That prayer made him smile again. A lot of you are not smiling, and not because you don't have a ministry, not because you are not talented, it's because you are obsessed by jealousy. And it is my prayer that, like Paul, maabot ta sa punto sa atong kinabuhing espirituhanhon nga maingon bitaw ta nga dili drama walay atik, it doesn't matter. That young businessman started well. In my time, it was not like that. But I'm happy for you and really mean it. It doesn't matter. There is joy. Amen. You really are happy for the inferior to be excellent. Then you silently rejoice. Sabi nga nung isang kwento, my son failed the board and my compare son passed the board. And how hard to attend the celebration party. But they were still there because they will rejoice with those who rejoice. It doesn't matter. Yeah, that statement is not overnight. A lot of brokenness in between. A lot of prayers. Now listen to me. It says there, verse 19, and we will close with that verse. In that, no? For I know, let's all read that. For I know, as you pray for me, and the Spirit of Christ helps me, this will lead to my deliverance. You know, that verse is so humbling. That even though we look at Paul as super, super mature, if you ask him, he's not yet there. He's on his way. And therefore, what is the way you deal with jealousy? Back to King Saul, Dr. Ted Engstrom, these preachers are preachers of the past. You might not know them now because the celebrity preachers are in YouTube, which is a lot of them are dangerous without scars. Dr. Ted Engstrom said in his sermon, if only King Saul, at the sight of jealousy, drowned jealousy in prayer, he could have survived. Amen. Think about that for a while. If you sense this morning, I'm not talking to you. God is talking to you. That you've been nourishing that jealousy for a long time. If you have ilunod na sa pag-ampo, drawn that to pray. Drawn, I don't know how to pronounce that. And then you will find, Ted Engstrom is right. Drawn that to prayer. So Paul said, verse 19, for I know that as you pray for me, what is that? And the Spirit of Jesus Christ helps me. General, no? And will lead to my deliverance. I think it's everything there. I think Paul includes not only deliverance from danger, deliverance from the devil, deliverance from deceit, deliverance from self. How do you cure jealousy? Ask others to pray for you. Start praying for the person you are jealous with. Diba? Listen kay pronounce ilang pangalan. Lord. Blah, 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 blah. Start praying for the success of others and mean it sincerely. Believe me, you will smile again. Let's get the principle. Paul is not naive to deny the reality of competition. You will not erase competition. There will be competition. Tama. Pero there are two things I want to say on that. The perils, the danger of a competitive heart is draining you with joy, and you will get a wrong joy. You are drained if you are very competitive. Walay kalipay. No? I am not even saying be mediocre, but I'm saying know your borderline. Basketball man lang na, di ba? Di ba building, ang sunong bagay naman mo? Mga pastor ba mo? Ngano sa dart? Ayaw na lang ng dart kay. Duol na sa kuha. Dati-dati ako ang champion dito eh. Sa dart, wad yung makapildi sa kuha. Karon maglisod na kong pildi ni Ricardo, maglisod na kong pildi ni Ormo, maglisod na kong magpildi. Ay, kapit ako kung maghulga. Gusto ba ninyo nang may trabaho pa kayo dito? I mean, are you with me? Masakit yung... Pero pastor, that's just a game. Bitaw, no? Seryoso kayo. I mean, people who are competitive, joy drains. Even churches that are competitive, you will not find joy there. Tama? And then number two, highly competitive individuals are unable to relate intimately with authenticity. Everybody is a suspect. Highly competitive schools, ay nako, have no time for, di ba? Dapat mga hawta sa declamation, hawta sa pagsasalaysay, hawta sa ana, di ba? Katakot yan. Apakos na ba Christian sa una? Eh, bright. Ano yung mga anak? Bawal na siguro na ron, no? Eh, bright. B, bright, bright. C, D. Then, section B. Oh, pati buguan lang na to. Luya, eh. I think that should, I don't know, educators, I'm not sure. Maybe you need to change those labels. No? Pero ang kahibulungan maigsuon. Ang mga bright way kalipay. Award, medal, kling, kling, kling. Pero mga bugo, puno sa kalipay. Bagsak na po kabay. Kapilar. Grabe ka na nag-card ka ng mga bright goal kayo. 96, nag-goal. Huhuy, 96. Pero kato mga 74, 79. Maghino, oh, nindot kaya akong kado. Reflect, reflect. Ano pa ako maestra sa una? Class, maglisod ko dala aning class record. Kay mga itlog ang inyong grado. I don't know. Uy, wala ba ako nag-ingon di mag-study, ha? May mga bata din na, oh, ingon sa pastor, mga mas nindot daw ang mga bugo. Wala akong naging una na, ha? Correction. What I'm saying is, do excellent people is different from highly competitive people. You will not smile again if you're competitive. Diba? Have you not seen my hair is black? No more white. Oh, siyempre. Competitive tayo eh. Dilo ay nagpatina na ko. I told you, mahal-mahal ba ni? Pero, ang patina ka, patina lang kay gusto ka. Amen? Pero kung, ah, patina, pastor, mas itumpa ng ako ang, wala na, kalipay, anak. That's true with gym. You go to the gym, just gym yourself, di ba? Okay lang yan. Enjoy! Pero mag-compare na ka, yung bilbilan niyo, wala na yan, sir. Wala na yung joy. So with churches, I hope there will be no like that in Chaibab. Other churches, this church is more, once the pressure is in, that's not true. Paul is not a narcissist to put self before the cause of the gospel, believe me. Pastor David was just installed. It is a reminder that above himself is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You are not above the gospel because the gospel is the only one that could change this society. I read Father Brennan Manning. You know why Paul would say, I rejoice? Because his eyes is focused on Christ and he is so powerfully obsessed with the gospel. Read Father Manning when he said, it's supposed to be a Protestant to say this, but a Roman Catholic says this. I believe he is a believer. He says, when God comes streaming into our lives with the power of his word, all he asks is we be stunned and surprised, that our mouths hang open and begin to breathe deeply. When you see the power of the gospel transforms people, you will have no time to be jealous who brought it. Amen? I like that praise. When I see how the gospel transforms a corrupt BIR into someone generous, when I see a molester transformed by the gospel into someone who admitted his sin and went to the court, you will be stunned and you have no more time to ask who preach it. I think that's the point. Amen? Paul is not paranoid by the evil motives of others. This time the issue is not the provocation of others. This time the issue is the response of us to the provocation. This time the issue is not your jealousy. You surrender naman sa Ginoo. Pero how do you respond to the others who are jealous of you? Paul is vulnerable enough to ask for prayers. And the next are timely application. Application number one, don't be naive. There are evil people in ministry doing good things. Don't be naive. So a lot of you easily impress. There are evil pastors who have double standard life, but they still preach. Lord, have mercy. I know a church in Davao who will not fire their pastor who is immoral because he is a good speaker. Thank God that church is closed already. And those of you who are members of that church and you supported this immoral pastor, you should repent. Because you're part of the destruction of the many lives. And Lord have mercy, if one of us fall, David, Sultan, Jerry, if we fall, huwag nang pahirapan ang church. You just quietly resign. Amen? And do not demand anymore for another speaking engagement. The gospel is pure, but the messenger of the gospel, though not so important as the gospel, must be clean, all God's people say. Ang oro ko nagsulti, anaha? Paul is not paranoid because Paul is also vulnerable enough to ask for prayer. Don't become a narcissist because ministry is not about you. Amen. Ministry is not about you. Song leading is not about you. Preaching is not about you. It's not wrong to admire, but it's not about them. It's about the message of God bigger than the messenger. Don't be ashamed. Don't be paranoid controller because wits and tares somehow must live together. Parable of Jesus saying, an evil person, jealous, planted tares in the wheat, and therefore the tares will choke the wheat. And the master woke up and said, saon nato ni, shall we pull out the tares? But there's a problem. The wheat and the tares, they look alike. You might pull the wheat. And the master said, wait until harvest time, because maklaro ra gyud. There will come a time that God will judge. One verse I respect in the Bible, God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, he will reap. Remember, that's not a joke. God hates sin. His grace, mercy. In fact, every time we sing, his mercy is new every morning. You know what God is doing? The judgment due you today, he restrains every day. Because his mercy is great. Ikaw ba makahilak, anak? Kada adlaw, how many judgments supposed to be yours? God restrain it because he's merciful. That's it. My dear friends, as I look at this text, one day God will separate the wheat and the tares. But what is the application? The application is this. Be sure, you are not a tare. You are a wheat. Amen. You cannot say, "What a kabal." No, no, no. Be sure that you are truly a child of God by faith in Christ. Amen. And I warn you, people of God, all and the rest of all Christians and pastors are human beings and therefore vulnerable. Will you please follow my daughter? Do not put any pastor on the pedestal. Pag natagak na, luoy kayong tanan. Christ is only in the pedestal. All God's people say. Now, there's a different meaning. Christ is first in my heart. Nice. But the real disciple says, Christ is everything to me. There's a difference. You cannot say that to your wife. You cannot say that to your pastor. You cannot say that to your children. You are everything to me. And others must not say that about you. It's only Christ who deserves that. Amen. So is Christ first correct? Meaning, he is one of the many important things in your life. A true disciple of Jesus will say, he is everything to me. I love my wife. I love my kids. But all these relationships, mabitaw na, no? All these relationships, having children around, paghatid sa school, pagbalik, maglagot kayta kay sa baan, would you please be reminded that all these relationships are temporary? One of these days, wala nang iahatid kasi graduate na. So you better choose whether you will be angry every morning and you realize they grow so fast, I might as well enjoy this while it's here. Amen. Tama? No, Pastor Dodong is now a widow. You do not see Pastor Dong. He is still crying because his wife, Kinging, passed away. And the Leones family is still mourning. Why? Because the relationship, the memories. You know, if you don't have memories, you won't grieve. Believe me. 2 weeks is done. But if there are many memories, grieving will be extended. Now, I think it would be good advice that while Jesus is everything to us, be wise to enjoy the relationship that God allows to you in this earth. Amen. When you go home, try to hug your kids, your wife. O sige na nga, your mother-in-law. Try to hug them. Relationships are temporary. You see? I think Pastor Dave and Fritz and sino ito? Ronakate, Francis and Bossing, Lolong, and si Jerry, and kayo lahat. What makes me smile in ministry are not the work here, but the laughter on the fifth floor, the coffee time, diba? Those jokes that we cannot tell to the church. Those were the moments I remember. Ay, nako. Pero masing mag-away na punta, delete na punta ang Instagram. What I'm saying is, take advantage of, you know, today is Sunday. Make Sunday a special day compared to the ordinary Sunday. Amen? Maski wa tay budget, ibahin nyo ang linggo, have a good lunch, di ba? Anong eat together, iba ito sa Lunes. This is a special day because while Jesus is everything to me, life under that, temporary. Let's close our service. Don't hesitate to ask others for prayers. Amen. Be sure to have at least 3-4 friends that when you text, they will drop what they're doing to pray for you. Do you have that? Be that person. Amen. Be that person. I am that person to others, and others are that to me. Pag mag-text ka, I'm sure when they say praying, they're really praying. And the ending conclusion of this message, the journey is called grace. Not 50-50, not I'll try. Lord, I deserve it. We don't deserve anything. God is gracious. He supplies strength. Receive it. Ask for it. Dispense it to others. And the journey will be a lot easier alone rather than alone. All God's people say, the journey will be a lot easier along rather than alone. So Paul, he said, doesn't matter. Sana, anak tanong, Sige lang. It doesn't matter. Bro, amen. I love this statement. It doesn't matter. Wala na bay sumpay. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Mamatay manghihapon na sila. Wala, wala. Wala yan na. Wala. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Mahapay naghihapon ng mga tawhana. May hugot pa, no? Dugay mo gulang mawala. I hope we come to the point in our spiritual lives that we can all smile. After all, like Joseph, you meant it bad, but God meant it for good. Amen. It's another version of it doesn't matter. You see? And then Joseph tells his brother, don't be hard on yourself. Forgive. Grabiha ganyan mga tawhana. Ay, tinuod pa ba ni sila? Don't be hard on yourself. Why can Paul and Joseph say that? I have only one suspicion. They met God. They met God. You meet God, you can forgive. You meet God, you can say, okay na to. Di lang ito magkapesa ha, mga next year na. Okay na to. Bayari itong 10 mil. Okay na to. We're not yet there. But we're on our way there. That's why the ending is, oh God, give me grace to mature in my faith, to get along. And when the getting along gets tough, I still can say, it doesn't matter. As long as the main thing is the main thing. All God's people say, amen. Please all rise. And before Ate Kate will lead us in the song, this is, I'm having a hard time, but I think the Holy Spirit wants us to do this. I only do altar invitation every communion. Pero right now, ganito ang ating gagawin. If you are up there, you cannot come. You can just sit down if you want. Kanina, you came to the altar asking for something. Aman? Tama? Now this time, you will come to the altar surrendering something. If God wants you to be here, please avail. Kneel down, 2-3 seconds. God, may never mind what people say. Just respond to the Lord. No? And as we sing that song, as the Lord convicts you, come. Settle things with God in repentance and redemption. Faith, please. As the song starts, freely come. Ako, I need to kneel down. I have a lot of things to do. Settle before.
It's only by
Before Pastor David will lead us in a closing prayer, be reminded that when you come to the altar, you're not asking God to love me. He already decided to love you, whether you come or not. Amen? Why are you on the altar? Because you want to settle something with Him. So do not impress God again. He knows a lot about us. Booking na kita sa Ginoo ba? But God says, doesn't cross my mind. Isn't our God good? All God's people say, amen. Sana we would say, doesn't matter. I don't know the context, but that's a beautiful, liberating word. So David, would you please lead us in prayer?
Let us pray. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, we come into your holy sanctuary not by accident, but by divine appointment. Thank you. Thank you for bringing us here, reminding us to address our jealousy, whether that be the size of a pebble or a boulder. Lord, we ask right now that may you shatter it. May you be the one, Lord God, to remind us to set our eyes on you. It doesn't matter what other people are having. It doesn't matter what people will say. Let us serve you with a pure heart, O God. Lord, continue to purge our motives. Let it be, Lord God, that may we serve you, knowing that we serve the one who loves us unconditionally. And so, Lord, our Heavenly Father, even as we set our eyes upon you, lead us this week. Continue, Lord God, to make us focus upon you. And at the end of it all, may we also say, as Paul has said, it doesn't matter what the other people say. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let us joyfully raise our hands and say, hear our prayer, O Lord. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, hear our prayers. Lord Jesus, our Master and Friend, hear our prayers. Holy Spirit, Convictor, Comforter, Companion, hear our prayers. People of God, remember to make Sunday special. Amen. Say to your neighbor, God's grace be with you. God's grace, God's grace, God's grace be with you. The pastors are in front and they will pray with you. If you need prayers, please do so. And Pastor David, you will be in the front to greet them with Dr. Jerry. Okay? God bless you. God bless you. Thank you for coming to church. Give your offering with a grateful heart.